Al Bernstein here at the Hard Rock Hotel and Casino, where we just had the weigh-in for the Lucas Matthysse Mike Dallas Jr. fight. And with me, Paulie Malignaggi, of course, world champion in the welterweight division, and my broadcast mate on Showtime. He'll be helping me call this fight for the broadcast in America. And Paulie, we saw Matthysse and Mike Dallas Jr. both weigh in under the 140-pound limit. This is a match that's fascinating because there's a lot at stake for both men.
Of course, and you know, there possibly is a big junior welterweight title shot at stake for the winner. So, you know, Matthysse is more so the guy expected to win it. He's the guy who's kind of been chasing Danny Garcia, so to speak. Mike Dallas is kind of a newcomer. He's had his ups and downs in his career, but he's a talented kid. You know, he's got fast hands, slick little boxing skills. So he's trying to pull off the upset. A lot at stake for both guys because the winner could really position himself near or at the 140-pound, the top of the 140-pound division.
Yeah, and in fact, the WBC has mandated that the winner of this fight, presumably, we'll get a shot at the winner of Danny Garcia and Zab Judah on February 9th. And of course, we know that no boxing organization ever gone back on their word, right?
Yeah, well, we can't take that as gospel, but we will hope the winners would fight each other.
Yeah, exactly. And the thing about this fight that's many things about it are intriguing. One is that Mike Dallas took it on relatively short notice because Hank Lundy was supposed to be the opponent, but he's had about 4 weeks' notice. And the second is that three fights ago he got with Virgil Hunter. Of course, he's a very fine trainer, Andre Ward's trainer, and a number of other important fighters. And they feel like they've made a difference, even at this point, in his boxing style.
You know, sometimes in your career, you just need a change. Sometimes it's just a fresh voice, a fresh face telling you what to do or teaching you. You know, sometimes you just stagnate and the training gets stale, you know. But a guy like Virgil Hunter is not only something new, but he's also an intelligent guy to have in the corner. So you would expect Mike Dallas to be making that progress. You would expect him to be making those leaps and bounds, so to speak, in his style and his boxing ability. So it'll be interesting to see, because this is kind of the test as to, you know, you're learning these new things, but now can you apply them? And not only can you apply them, but can you apply them at a high level, like fighting a fight against a guy like Lucas Matthysse?
Yeah, and you mentioned a high level. There may not be a higher level at the 140-pound division, because Matthysse might be the best in the division. He is a fighter that puts a lot of pressure on you.
Yeah, man, he's a scary guy to fight. You know, everybody that ends up fighting this guy always talks about, man, he hits so hard, and you know, it's tough, you know, not only is he putting pressure on you, but when you go on a guy like that, it's putting pressure on you, and he hits that hard, that pressure feels like twice as much. You know, your brain can kind of get into a panic mode if you're not mentally stable and calm in the ring. So it's a step up for Mike Dallas, and the pressure and the punching power is going to probably will be something new to him, because it's not just a pressure guy. It's a guy who knows how to put the proper amount of pressure and cut the ring off the right way. So it'll be interesting to see how that Mike Dallas handles it, because he does have speed and he does have boxing ability, but can he handle it under that sort of pressure?
And finally, in the co-main event, Selcuk Aydin, a fighter who came here from Turkey and fought very well against Robert Guerrero in his last fight, though he didn't beat Guerrero, taking on Jesus Soto Karass. This fight has the makings of a wild brawl.
Well, you know, there's the old cliche, styles make fights. I'm sure you heard it a million times, Al. Well, this kind of fight is really has barn burner written all over it, because these guys both don't like to back away from a good fight. You know, they both don't shy away from it. Jesus Soto Karass has some pretty decent boxing skills, but he likes to get in there and bang, or he can easily be lured into a boxing fight or a big a brawl. Aydin looks to bang it out with you from the start. He's more of got that machismo style, and you know, he's got a lot of experience. He's got a lot of big amateur pedigree, and he's been in with some of the top fighters in Europe, as well as the fight with Guerrero. So, you know, it's a fight with a lot at stake. The winner kind of propels himself into the big welterweight picture, but at the same time, it's an entertaining fight. It's a fight that has the potential to probably steal the show, and that's what I expect, honestly. I think that's the best fight on the card.
All right, and of course, Paulie, who is at the very top of the welterweight division, be defending his title shortly this year. Just briefly, you're kind of in a mode where you're searching to figure out what fight you're going to get. If you had to tell us, just when do you think you're going to be back in the ring?
We're aiming towards April. You know, that's what we're aiming towards. We hope that we can get something done. I'm confident my promoter can get something done. They always have the answers, and they have a lot of fighters. So I think it's a situation that we can figure out, and I got my fingers crossed.
All right, well, we hope that you get exactly the opponent you want, but I'm going to have to do without him as a broadcast partner when he does that. Maybe I'll be talking about his fight. So, Paulie, thanks very much.
Thanks, Al.
Paulie Malignaggi, and we want to remind you that we'll have full post-fight coverage on the Boxing Channel of Saturday night's battle between Matthysse and Dallas, and so keep it right here.